Hello and welcome. Thank you so much for watching. This show is all about giving you insights and showcasing brands that help you to live your best life and give you confidence. As always, I want to kickstart your morning with some motivational advice to help you to feel inspired and energized to start your day. Today, I want to talk about the importance of avoiding getting too comfortable with anything in your life. The truth is, becoming too comfortable equals complacency. When we begin to become complacent, we tend to take for granted the things we once appreciated and were excited to have. When we become too comfortable, we lose the motivation to work and put effort into things because we've lost sight of the value and joy having these things bring. This can go from anything in your life, from your job, relationships, and even life in general. By practicing gratitude and appreciation instead of becoming complacent, we restore our motivation and realize the importance of putting in consistent effort and value into all areas of our life. Nothing is guaranteed, so the next time you find yourself getting too comfortable with anything, remind yourself that your effort and time is required to fully maximize every area of your life. Life is a gift, and we must practice constant gratitude for the things we have, as they can be taken away from us if we take them for granted. As Oprah Winfrey says, if you look at what you have, you'll always have more. If you look at what you don't have in life, you'll never have enough.
Stay tuned. Coming up after the break.
And you guys sell such expensive houses on Selling Sunset. Let's talk about the most expensive house that you've sold.
I sold an off-market. The most expensive one was $7 million in LA. And then after that, I sold 5s and 4s and 3s. And, you know, I'm in Miami now. I'm dealing with different price points. So I even sell $300,000, $400,000 condos. So I do different transactions, different price points. But the most expensive one was $7 million.
What does luxury mean to you?
Luxury. In India, I discovered that true luxury isn't something you buy off a shelf. True luxury is a feeling that you are the Maharani of your world. And it can be all designed around you. All the beauty is yours. All the music is yours. India showed me that luxury doesn't follow designers and brands. True luxury follows its own heart.
Incredible India.
Natural sweetener, Flavor All. 20 flavors to choose from. The perfect substitute for sugar and artificial sweeteners.
Flavor All by Greenish.
Flavor All from Greenish, now available at Rexall Pharmacies.
Next up on the show, we have Maya Vander from the hit show Selling Sunset on Netflix. Maya, thank you so much for joining us today. How are you doing? I see you're busy.
I'm doing well. Exactly. I'm holding this phone and I'm feeding a baby. So if she's going to lose it, I want to apologize. I'm going to do my best to keep her quiet.
Well, congratulations on your baby. And honestly, I honestly admire you for balancing it all. I'm sure it's extremely difficult, especially with everything that's going on in the world.
It's been challenging, you know, like between work, the show, obviously it's chaotic on its own, and then have two little babies at home. Yeah. No help. I'm trying to do my best to balance, but it's definitely not always easy.
I can imagine. So let's talk about it. Selling Sunset. When did you join the Oppenheim Group?
I joined back, I want to say in 2015, around that time. I was the first female agent, I'm proud to say. I used to door knock up in the hills, and I used to see Jason's marketing package on those houses, and I'm like, how am I going to compete with this guy? Like, he has a brilliant marketing. So a few months later, he actually approached me and he asked me to join, and I joined.
Wow. I'm sure it's been quite the journey ever since. And speaking of that, I think I just had asked you this before we started filming, but what was your reaction when you found out that your job was going to be a reality show? Like, what was the first reaction you had?
Yeah, and it took a while, you know? Like, it took us 2.5 years between shooting the demo and actually pitch, you know, the show being aired to season one. I was excited. I thought it has a great potential. You know, I think it's always good to have stuff like that because it helps your business, I would imagine. So we were very excited, all of us. And we knew it's going to be a good one. We just didn't know how big it's going to get. And season three really like took it to the next level as far as successful, you know, product. Yeah,
definitely. And of course, it's no surprise that you work in an all female brokerage. How is that? Is there challenges?
So, you know, it's not only females, actually. We have a couple of male.
Oh, okay.
But they just not really make it to the show because nobody cares.
They want to see beautiful women instead.
They want to see what Christine is wearing.
Yeah. So has it changed the dynamic kind of being on camera? Is it natural for you to still do your job, or are you kind of aware of the cameras when you're filming? How does that work?
No, especially I like filming real estate scenes because that's what I'm used to do.
Yeah.
So for me, I don't have to act or do anything or, you know, be out of my comfort zone.
Yeah.
And you know, when we film at the office, you know, like we have four cameras. We just basically kind of like talk and then things being said, and we sometimes forget that the cameras are there because, you know, it's a big, you just don't pay attention at some point.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. And you guys sell such expensive houses on Selling Sunset. Let's talk about the most expensive house that you've sold.
I sold an off-market. The most expensive one was $7 million in LA. And then after that, I sold 5s and 4s and 3s. And, you know, I'm in Miami now. I'm dealing with different price point. So I even sell $300,000, $400,000 condos. So I do different transaction, different price points, but the most expensive one was $7 million.
Mm-hmm. And I know you said that real estate comes naturally to you. So when did you start your whole real estate career?
I started my real estate career 8 years ago. I was licensed and I joined different companies in the beginning before Jason. And then Jason asked me if I want to join. And then since then I'm with Jason. So 2015, we are 2020. So yeah, it's been like 8 years since 2015. Yeah,
definitely.
And it's not always easy. I always say that. It's not always easy.
I was going to say, you know, our show is all about inspiration and inspiring the next generation. And, you know, when you see the show, it's so glamorous. You see all these beautiful, expensive houses. And we see you guys at all these beautiful events. You know, let's talk about some challenges as a real estate agent that you guys face, you personally or just in general. What kind of challenges do you face as a real estate agent to, you know, get these expensive houses sold?
So, you know, the challenge with real estate, you don't always have loyal clients.
Yeah.
Deals, you know, can go south anytime. There is lack of consistency at times. You can go to dry months without closing a house. So it's not as glamorous. And definitely every transaction doesn't close over a phone call. So it's, you know, it's not easy as we see it on the show. And it's not just like putting a cute dress and cute shoes and boom, you sell a house. So it's more than that. It takes longer time.
Yeah, I can imagine. I'm sure it's a lot of work. So how has your life changed since the show? Because, you know, Selling Sunset has become very successful. It's a great show. I love it. So yeah, what's changed for you since the show has started?
So, you know, people recognize you on the street, that's for sure. You just have more recognition. People approach you from all over the world. You know, look, I mean, I still do real estate. I don't feel like I changed personally. You just get more recognition in general, which is a nice thing. You know, it's been very busy and hectic. You inspire people. People message you from all over the world.
Yeah.
You know, it's been amazing. I think the show has such a success and you do inspire people. And, you know, it's almost like I don't have time to mentor people, but I try to respond to emails and give some helpful advice.
Mm-hmm.
You know, as far as real estate, you people approach you from all over the world, so you definitely get nice recognition international as well, because obviously the show is from all over.
Definitely, yeah. And you know what? I think it's really inspirational that you're balancing it all. If you're doing an interview right now, you were messaging a client. So how do you balance it all? How do you balance life and the show and everything?
My son, thankfully, is going to daycare next month. So I can't wait. I mean, I love my son, but you know, he also needs it too. He's 16 months. He needs this socialization. So unfortunately with COVID, it's kind of suck, but thankfully next month. Mm-hmm. And we might have to hire someone part-time because I've been really busy and I can't take the baby to a showing all the time. It's just not the ideal approach. Thankfully, my husband works from home right now, so it helps, but he's also very busy. Mm-hmm. So when the baby's not going to sleep at night and it's quiet,
yeah,
then I can, do my follow-ups with real estate, check new inventories, send, emails to clients. But during the day, it's a little bit difficult. I'm not good.
No, I can imagine, but you're doing a great job at balancing it all. I don't think I'd be able to do an interview, do message clients, do a show. So you're doing a great job. So what are your current projects? What are you working on now?
So I have a couple of clients interesting actually in purchasing in Miami that are moving from overseas in California. So I'm working on like very large, couple of million dollars for them, for like five individual clients. Then Primo in LA actually that I'm working. So, if they will come down to, to look and be serious about it, then I'll have to probably fly to LA for like a day or two to show them around. Yes, I can ask Jason or one of the girls to do it, but I like to really be involved with my clients and, make sure I give them the right guidance. Mm-hmm. So working with a couple of good ones in LA. So we'll see. Both LA and Miami. And then even, I'm doing rentals, I'm doing leases. I always think transaction is transaction and clients are, you can never know where the referral can come. Mm-hmm. So I never underestimate even a $3,000 rental. That's just my approach.
Yeah, no, definitely. I'm actually currently looking for a house and it's challenging because, you keep looking and it's hard to find something you actually like love, So I'm in the process of doing that. I can totally understand.
It is nice. Like you don't always have to look at 30 houses, but if you go to a house, even if it's your second house and you feel something and like, wow, this is great, go for it. If you don't, then you can go and keep looking and then you can even see 40 houses until you'll know the house. When you see it.
That's what everyone tells me. It's just like love, right? It's just like you, when you know, you know.
You know what? Yep. That's how me and my husband bought our house. We looked at maybe two places before. I didn't go crazy and look for 1 year.
Yeah.
It took us 3 weeks and we were like, let's do this.
Yeah. Also, I did see your colleague, Chriselle, is on Dancing with the Stars. What do you think about that? Would you ever do the show?
I was going to message her congratulations. I think it could be a fun experience, actually, mm-hmm. Dancing with the Stars. I don't know if I would do it. I'm not a good dancer, but I think it could be a fun experience. I think she would be in that. And I was actually thinking to send her a message to congratulate her. Because I heard rumors, but now it's official. So I'm going to message her.
Yeah, I think that's amazing. And she might be on the show actually in a few weeks. So we definitely will congratulate her. And last but not least, what is going to be the future of Selling Sunset? Is there going to be another season? Because I know we're all really excited for it and excited for the show.
So I would hope it will be another season because Heather's still going to probably need to get married. She just got engaged a month ago. So.
Yeah.
I think that could be interesting. Then obviously,
Who got engaged?
Heather got engaged.
Oh, yes, I saw that. Yes, okay, yeah.
She got engaged. Obviously, we want to see Crazy Christine, what she's up to. She's in vacation right now on a boat somewhere while I'm, feeding a baby here with spit. It's like everything, the story of my life. I think it would be interesting to also see what's going on with Chriselle because. We obviously went through a breakup last season and, she's been very professional all throughout. So, we'll see how that goes. I think that could be interesting. I would hope they will show me maybe doing a look. I mean, I'm going to be in Miami full time mostly, but I'm going to try if they do season 4 to somehow incorporate myself in the show just because I also still work with clients in LA. So mm-hmm. I'm not going to be there full time. I'm not going to move to LA full time, but trust me, if the first client who is serious, I'm going to be on the, 6 a.m. flight to show properties. So we'll see what happened with that. And as you know, Brett is doing his own thing now, although he works with Jason on project, but mm-hmm. he is is on Broadway now. So I think it could be a cool fourth season.
Yeah, I hope so. I love it. I watch it with my mom and it's really inspiring, honestly, seeing all the beautiful houses, seeing you guys and everything. It's a great show and it's so cool that it's actually, I see it's a show, but it's really your lives, right? That's really you just doing your job. Yeah.
I mean, yes, like, look, I would love to obviously do a show more real estate, but the people who watch the show, they want to see our personal life. And I think that's a nice mix. I think Adam is doing a great job, you know, with the mix of like sexy houses, real estate, successful women, you know, doing real estate. And obviously in the show, everything looks easy. Like I said earlier, it's not an easy thing to just sell a house. It takes sometimes months and sometimes it takes a year. Like,
yeah,
it takes you two, three months. But I mean, I'm working with a client now. We are looking at a house, then we're looking at a condo, then we're back to a house. So, you know, clients can be indecisive.
Yeah.
So it's not always easy, but I love it. And I think it's a nice, it's a great profession to be in.
Yeah.
And I'm glad we inspire people.
Yeah, definitely. Well, thank you so much, Maya, for making the time to come on the show today. I really appreciate it. I know you have your hands full. So thank you and congratulations on all your success. And we hope to have you back soon.
Thank you. And I want to apologize. Looking like shit, basically.
No, you look beautiful.
Glamorous and with a crying baby and a barking dog. But you know what? This is life. This is the reality.
No, you look beautiful, so you don't have to worry about it.
Thank you so much, Daryl.
All right, thank you. Talk to you
thank
soon.
You.
Okay,
bye.
Bye. Tag TV is available on Roku, Amazon Fire TV, Apple and Android TVs, as well as on Apple and Android phones. Watch us live through YouTube and Facebook.